That's all I wanted. But I guess even that's not gonna work out.
Wow.
We'll take this back to town and tell him you're dead. That should be enough to satisfy the exorcists and get them to call off the search.
Jesus, you just gonna cut the dude's tail off like that? Fuck, Velvet! Music is so beautiful. We just gonna let the music ride for a second. Alright, that's enough. Alright, what it do, y'all? It's your man Mike Titan, the Gaming Savant, bringing y'all another episode of Titan Plays, and today we are playing Tales of Berseria, the new Tales game that just came out this past January. JRPG is what you can essentially call this one. Now, as far as the story goes, I'm only about a couple hours, I'll probably say like an hour or two into the main storyline. Things got turned really quick in this game. So essentially, you play as this girl named Velvet. She is a Therion, which is essentially like a half-human, half-demon. Essentially, long story short, her older sister was killed when like this, like demons attacked her village and like allegedly killed her sister. So she lives with her sister's husband or widowed husband, Arthur, who's like this older dude, and her little brother, Laffy. So long story short, Arthur kills Laffy to like prevent the demons from doing something. Anywho, Arthur kills Laffy and then puts Velvet in jail, and Velvet just goes full rage mode where essentially she just wants to kill Arthur no matter what. That's essentially what the story is at. There's actually some very good graphic and savagery cutscenes, which I don't have access to because I'm already past that part. But you can just go look it up on YouTube, and I'm telling you, like she gets real savage. Now, don't mind the outfit right now. This is just her main outfit. You know what? Just for the sake of the video, we'll change her outfit. So this is her... No. So this is her normal outfit. Of course, yes, RPGs, under boobs, right. And this is her prisoner clothes. Yes, 3 years in the same clothes, side boob. Yeah, whatever. All right. I don't know, she just looks, like, to me, she just looks weird wearing this outfit and the cowboy hat. Like, she looks regular wearing the villager clothes. I'll keep the villager clothes on. Alright. So, essentially, what we are doing now is we are trying to find a way to Magland? Mainland? Something like that. Where she can go kill Arthur. And, just gonna generate a cutscene? Alright, cutscene.
A storehouse?
That smell. Flamestone.
Flamestone?
Also known as Malkianite, a rare mineral only found in Northgand. Mix it with sulfur and you get explosives! Mix it with oil and you get fuel.
Sounds dangerous, if it's true.
Believe me or not, it's your call.
Looks like the boy got away.
Well, we're in the city now.
Well, then let's scout for the Maritime Guild. Whoever's in charge of all these storehouses must have their hands in the shipping trade and shipbuilding.
And we could use a true sailor, if we can find one.
Now that's a plan I endorse! We dodged the sea's murderous grasp this time, but who's to say our luck will hold?
We should look for some weapons, too, if I'm to be any use in a fight.
You're still wearing one.
Nope, not an option.
Okay. Tranquil Borel Capital. All right. Hella Walls? All right, so essentially the two people that you saw, Marigale, or whatever, she's a witch. So essentially, when Velvet escaped prison, she met these other two people that she's with that are prisoners. Like, you can't play as them yet, because they're just kind of there for, like, cutscenes and stuff. But essentially, she met Marigold, who was a witch, and she met the other dude, who is a demon as well. For some reason, he has a real, like, hold on the sword. So, yeah, for some reason, he won't use it in a battle. Don't know why. We haven't gotten that far yet. I'm sure we'll find out. But, yeah, he won't use the sword at all. This game is so beautiful. Granted, And originally, this was supposed to be like a PS3 game, and they just kind of ported it over to PS4 and PC. Wait, does that say reduce or increase fire range attacks? Okay, reduce amount of mana and stuff, so. Okay, but yeah, I mean, this is still like, for a Tales game, like, this is still a very good game. 60 FPS, I'm playing on PC, for y'all that wanna know, I bought it on PC, because this would be the type of game that I would play multiple times. Maybe not at once, but like, over the span of me having it, I'd play it multiple times. Yeah, Arturius is Arthur. That's the dude that like killed her little brother and allegedly killed her older sister as well, and kind of left her for dead.
When I grow up, I'm gonna be an exorcist.
Me too. I want to protect my mommy and daddy.
Hold up. Exorcists are warriors who protect. You can't just protect your parents. You've got to protect everyone.
Oh.
It is. And it's precisely because the exorcists are working so hard that we look up.
Yeah! Exorcists are the best!
They're treated like, I suppose, to normal people.
Yeah, so essentially, exorcists are people that can kill demons. Velvet is a Therion, which she actually eats demons to, like, gain powers and stuff. Essentially, I think the whole plot is supposed to be around how, like, Arthur killed her little brother to get power to fight the demons, and now everybody thinks that he's like a hero and stuff when he's like, she really, like, he is, but then again, he isn't to her. Because here's the thing, and I've read this with the reviews that I looked up on this game before I started playing it. Like, you don't play a good guy in this game. You play Velvet, who's kind of low-key an anti-hero of sorts. Like, all she cares about is killing Arthur. Like, she don't even care if she died. Like, all she wants is to make sure that Arthur dies for what he did. And that could mean, like, fucking up the world, too. But she's like, I don't care. I want to kill that fool for, you know, all the bad stuff that he did. Oh, there's some stuff down this hallway. Always gotta check stuff in alleyways. All right. So now she's a sassy cowboy villager, I guess? I don't know. Whatever. All right, let's talk to you. Hey, buddy.
Is this a shipping guild?
Damn that dial! What does he think he's doing by trying to resist? We wouldn't be in this mess if he were dead.
Excuse me. I need a ship repaired.
Sorry, but we can't help.
What makes you say that?
Guild business is currently suspended.
Bitch, do you not see my-
By the order of Exorcist Teresa of the Abbey.
Oh, she's one of those exorcist people.
Lady Teresa.
Number two, did I give you permission to speak?
Damn. I feel like we're gonna have to fight her at some point in this game.
Lady Teresa, how long must this punishment of ours last? You know it was all Dial's fault, don't you, my lady?
I know Dial was the one smuggling Flamestone, but your guild, through its negligence, shares responsibility. This rule was set down by the Abbey to maintain order. Do you disagree with it?
A little bit.
No, my lady.
We will capture, interrogate, and sentence Dial. When this has been accomplished, you will be free to continue business.
So I guess we gotta find Dial then.
And you, girl. Aren't you cold dressed like that?
I've just arrived from the south. I wasn't aware Northgand was so cold.
Hutch! A young woman ought to keep herself warm.
Thank you for your concern.
Oh, so it's not on this outfit, but on her regular outfit, she has bandages on her hand.
My,
I guess it'll make more sense for me to switch
so
to that.
This is how the Abbey flexes its muscle, hmm? Cruel, cruel world these days.
I see how things stand. If I catch this Dial person, you can repair my ship, right?
Sure, but I warn you, he's a demon. He escaped after killing a bunch of soldiers who tried to capture him. Can't be done without an exorcist.
He's from a small village outside the city. If you're doing this, I'd imagine that's a good place to start searching. He's a brute with the head of a lizard. I'd prepare for bloodshed.
Hey!
Anything could happen. It's best to keep our options open.
While you wait, find us a good navigator.
Savage! Okay. So we gotta go find Dial, get the ship fixed. What does that leaf mean over there?
I see. So we're hunting a reptilian demon called Dial, are we?
We'll check out his hometown first.
Have fun, you kids!
You aren't coming along?
I'm afraid I've got bigger fish to fry at the moment. That little matter of tracking down my betrayer. Besides, if I stick around, I'm not so sure I wouldn't wind up as someone's midnight snack.
My palate has standards. High standards.
All the more reason to skedaddle!
It's an inside joke because, like, Velvet eats demons, like, with her giant demon hand, which I'll show y'all once I get into combat. So she was just afraid of getting eaten, which is funny.
Let me get this straight, Alpha Area. You want to form...
Correct!
What is this?
The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Is that it? Indeed.
I'll...
Excellent! We shall be victorious in this year. Let us toast to...
This isn't a snowball fight.
Once they eliminate Beta Area, the Alpha and Gamma Force exhausted.
These kids really fight...
All's fair in...
All's fair in snow and war. Funny. Alright. So this is a church. Don't mind me, guys. I'm just over here looking for stuff. You all can hail me. My name is Velvet. That's the color of my hair. I wear glasses and a 10-gallon cowboy hat, even though this is kind of taking place in Japan. But I rule all of you now, and praise the base god. All right, we're done here. On to the next one. Dialin. Who the fuck?
Thank goodness I was here. But any further attacks and...
An exorcist. Was that Dial she slew?
No. It wasn't a lizard demon. Are you crying? It's just... Everything that's going on. Demons run rampant in the Outlands. And yet the Abbey has explicitly chosen not to come to their aid. It's true we haven't the forces to be everywhere at once, and the people of the Outlands refuse to obey the Abbey's rules. It's a heartless decision, I know, but it follows from the Abbey's perfect logic and principle.
Oh, she's one of those.
Why make excuses to me?
I'm not making... My name is Eleanor Hume. I am a praetor patrolling for the Abbey. What is your business here?
We heard there was a murderous demon in this town who fled from Hellevise.
The Shipping Guild incident, yes. I've been looking into it, but I haven't found any clues yet. Worry not. We will track down that foul demon and put it to the sword.
So you're just gonna, like, join up with us? Oh, wait, she's leaving.
Did the exorcist lady go away?
Yeah, she's gone.
Oh, good. I didn't want us to get eaten.
Eaten?
I mean, I don't know anything about a demon.
It's fine. You can tell me. I'll keep it a secret. I promise.
He looks real cringy
There's
right there.
There's a lizard demon in a cave to the north. He said he'd eat the whole village up if I told anyone. I'll give you these. Don't tell anybody, all right?
Oh, thanks.
Got it. That's a promise.
A cave to the north.
Gotta say, the folks here really don't trust the exorcists, do they? This is actually rather good. What's wrong? A worm?
Nothing. Can't taste a thing.
Huh?
Oh, so I guess she's losing her taste buds.
We learned what we need to. Let's look for that cave. That woman said she was patrolling for the
Abbey. They're handpicked agents who travel the kingdom gauging the Abbey's success in the demon fight. They also make sure the other exorcists are... I suppose you could liken them to military. Since the Abbey imposes so many rules on the populace, they want to show they're above...
But if they need to police themselves, isn't that as good as announcing...
Some would say it's more honest this way. Idealism alone won't... Maybe that's why our determined little exorcist was crying.
I bet you're right.
Although it's best not to take a woman's tears at face value.
Huh?
Just some common wisdom.
You heard it from him first. Never take a woman's tears at face value. If my fiance heard me say that, she'd probably slap the shit out of me. But she's not here right now, so... And hopefully she doesn't watch this video. But if it does, hey, how you doing? Love you. All that good stuff. Nice, you got any new weapons for me? Amber daggers. All right, we'll get one for you. Amber talisman. All right, well, I guess that kind of makes sense. All right, let's save here before we go fight Dylan or Dylan, however you want to pronounce his name. Ooh, looks so beautiful in here. All right, first dungeon. Let's see how this goes. Don't mind me, I'm just grabbing stuff. You can destroy crack boulders by pressing A. Destroying boulders could open up new paths, and destroy boulders will not reappear, so make it a point to destroy them. Okay. Jesus! Damn it, woman!
Ugh. What's that smell?
Oil?
Okay. Not gonna be going that way. Okay, that's it? You're not giving me... Okay. He didn't give me anything. Jerk. That's the thanks I get for saving you? I don't know how you got locked in the box in the first place, but whatever. That's fine. I didn't want anything anyways. I just didn't spend 25 of my hard collected cat orbs to get you out for nothing. But you know, whatever. Whatever. It's why you can't trust felines. That's why it's true what they say. Dog is a man's best friend. Maybe even a woman's best friend too.
So it was tar we were smelling. Watch your step. You won't get out if you get stuck.
That's cool. Let's see what's down here first. It's like a scavenger hunt. It's like we're in the Girl Scouts or Boy Scouts and... We're scavenging, hunting for stuff. This is cool.
You know what they say, falling off a rock only makes a...
When there's nothing else to use as footing, there's a gap, there may be a boulder in there. Okay,
I'm
got
going
you.
To jump.
Don't fall and crack your skull.
That's not nice. I guess that's where I'm supposed to go. This is where I came in at? No, this is not where I came in at. Don't mind me. I'm just sitting here collecting these orbs, looking for Dylan. Oh my God, what the fuck are you?
Oh, it's ready to fight.
Out of my way.
Nice.
Come on, really?
Like, I want to fight this thing, but you know what? Fuck, let's just fight
it. Are you ready for this?
Oh my God. You know what? We can beat the the demon thingy, we just gotta take out these smaller ones first. Oh my god, I just died. Okay. Because I do not... Alright, give me a life bottle. And we go, just gonna get the fuck out of here.
Another day.
Yeah, we're not even gonna fuck with that. That's what I figured. We couldn't beat that thing because it had like the little thing around it. So typically in Tails games, there will be enemies that for whatever reason will be at the beginning of the game, but they're too much for you to fight, and they'll have like that little purple shit around them. That means that they're way higher level than what you're supposed to be, and you're supposed to come back and fight them. They're kind of like I guess you can say jukes. I guess you could say like high level mini bosses.
Not as far as I'm concerned.
What sort of?
A yaksha. I'm a war demon.
A war demon.
And what about you?
I'm a Therian.
Therian? That's a new one for me.
A monster that feeds on foes to gain power.
Hmm. A woman who devours her hag. Am I right?
What?
Whoa. You've got the death glares down at least.
That's funny. You tried to call her a hag because she's a woman.
An exorcist.
Did he slip and fall?
No, he was thrown in!
Why'd she have to yell? Hitting all of enemies' weak points during a combo will activate a weak point combo, greatly increasing your damage. Demon Dial is weak against demi-humans, fire, earth, so Velvet's harsh rebuttal to Searing Edge to Tearing Thorn will activate a weak point combo. Okay, so harsh rebuttal, Searing Edge to Tearing Thorn. Okay, let's try that for X. Harsh rebuttal, Searing Edge, Tearing Thorn.
On to battle. We found our murderer. More fools from Helaves came hunting me down, did you?
It seems that way.
Combos.
See this? You're in my way.
Oh, so I gotta dodge attacks. Okay. Got you.
That
didn't kill him? Thank you. I was like, you're not dead yet?
I won't die yet.
Not until I have my revenge.
Why is your mouth barely moving?
Revenge?
The bastards at the guild who tried to kill me. They want me to take the fall for their smuggling operation.
Wait, are you saying the whole guild was involved?
Of course. You think a second-rate sailor like me could pull off all that mischief by myself? I mean, sure, I was in on it. Helping them wasn't without its benefits.
He has a point. It would take more than one person to dig that tunnel into the warehouse.
Problem is, our extra-legal activities were a little too successful. The Abbey was bound to notice us at some point.
And dead men tell no tales. So they blame it on you and kill you to cover it up. Looks like it's not going quite how they planned.
How do you mean to get this revenge of yours?
A raid on Helavies. I'll kill the lot of them. This I swear.
That would be suicide. Do you have any idea how many exorcists are around?
They'll hunt me down no matter what I do. I just want the guild to pay for what they did to me. That's all I wanted. But I guess even that's not gonna work out.
Wow.
We'll take this back to town and tell him you're dead. That should be enough to satisfy the exorcists and get them to call off the search.
But why?
I have my reasons. We need a boat fixed for starters. Plus, if you stir things up after I leave, I imagine it'll slow down anyone who's following me.
If that's what you want, miss, I won't let you down.
Jesus, she just gonna cut the dude's tail off like that? Fuck, Velvet! Jesus, she was just like, fuck it, slash! You can use a dino power pushing LT while inside a dungeon. Using the dino power teleport directly to the dungeon's engine. Nice. Yeah, like she didn't give no fucks. She was just like, hey, give me your tail. What? Slice! Jesus, I'm like, Velvet, bruh. But she's been through some things, so I can understand slightly how she feels. Do I get the option to kill him? That'd be awful cool if I got the option to let him live
or
not.
By the way, how on
luck.
The village I grew up in was the dullest, gloomiest place ever. But look at me now. If I could do it all again.
I see.
Nice. All right, so we got that done. All right, y'all, so that's gonna do it for today's video. Damn, Velvet's a fucking savage, though. Did y'all see it? She just sliced that dude's tail off, and then it's just like, hey, I'll take this. You stay alive for some odd reason, because she's an anti-hero, I guess, now. But I do appreciate everybody for watching. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It's your man, Mike Titan, and I'm out this piece. Gone.